This is just an extension for the video creating PHP 7 development platform. So looks like our PHP PB that was not working there. I think it's just that thing, but it looks like so the URL works now. What was the issue? So let's see. Everything here, it was actually all right. Actually, the primary issue was here. What we are using this. We probably were following the instruction and did not put much thought. So actually they are the same background instance, right? So this PHP 7 dev and the PHP baby, they are on the same IP. So it has to be like this, actually they have to be the same. We are using 7.1. Okay, after that it actually worked all right. Now it's a matter of installing it, creating a database, and then our concept is how to create a new site in NGINX, in backend platform, all those things, but installing PHP PB, that is not our core purpose. So I did change that NGINX PHP PB config. I probably can bring everything back. Okay, so service NGINX reload and restart. I hope that it still works. Okay, so in var dub is php bb3, that's where you okay, so we tried this, but it's not required. Okay, this is the file as it is. We also actually renamed htaccess to see if htaccess was causing that trouble, but htaccess as it is was also good. Install, I think this is not really that important. So I just want to see, allow URL, open, okay, MB string extension, supported database, MySQL, MySQL server, we are not there, Oracle, no. So these are some of the stuff that came in the package. Optional modules, image magic. We did not install explicitly. Like we might have to give a database name. MySQL extension, that's what you need. Server name. We probably could use the IP. Okay, we just need to create it here and then let's see. Okay, MySQL databases. Data page name php bb use php bb show tables. Okay, there is no table set, but what we need a database user. Create user php bb identified by we have to grant permission. Let's see, we might have to use localhost or IP. So 192.168.7.7. Database, I think it's probably 3603 or something by default. So let's remove this part. Connection refused. If I used localhost, MySQL minus U, PHP PP minus P. Okay, so that part is working, so it can be this one here. Okay, let's see. If I keep it just the default one, it's not taking it. If I put PHP BB, will it take it? Usually HTTP is not supposed to be here. Okay, one other thing we can do, we can actually configure it from here. Anyway, it's a PHP BB installation aspect of it. So we created the database, that's okay. Database has this localhost. We actually tried this, right? Okay, let's follow. Okay, yeah, that probably is what it is. Vagrant. Yeah, that I was kind of thinking. If vagrant is the thing to give as the user, what is the password? port empty. Database name PHP PP. Okay, this is the configuration file. We have to remove the install directory, otherwise it might bring us back to the installer if it sees that it is there. Let me see. I might have to put that configuration here. It's going to install. Let's see. Sublime part, did I not save it? Documents, download, config.php, copy. Okay. Yeah, PHP BB. I used to use this long back. People used to use this long back. I'm not sure that people probably don't use it that much nowadays, or probably the newer versions people use. Why? LS minus LA. and just for debugging. It is going back to installer. It might be the case the configuration we are keeping, it just needs the proper configuration. Okay, install rm. I can see the previous, I think there was a y install is there. Yeah, this part actually is not really required, you can ignore it completely. Nano app.php. Actually what I should do, I should say php db config file. What I am doing, it was just a case. We need to know what is the config file for config.php file. We can say that config.php, so it is there, config.php, right? It's config.php, it is there. There is one another possibility I have to see, but okay, before going into that, sudo nano etc mginx php. Actually the folder that I am actually using, that is actually this thing. Let's reload, restart. So okay, at least the it's pointing, it's going to the right place. SQL error, the table does not exist. I think that we did not create the, what would I say, the database itself, right? MySQL database is there. I think actually as part of the installation, it is supposed to install all those, create all those database, PHP, PP3, we can try to see if this SQL script is there. Okay, another thing, let's see. It's another directory. Actually I have deleted this thing. So I probably don't have any backup of the database files. Anyhow, we can just take the database file and run it. This is not the, this is not what it should be. I think it should be there. I'm just trying an alternate way. Anyway, it's not anything important. I don't see a separate thing. We probably have to download, and inside the download there will be something. The database file should be there and we can just use it. Okay, we are actually using PHP VB 3.3, that means 3.3. Okay. This schemas CD schema data schema JSON schema data. Okay, just the data insert. Okay, this might work, but though there is no guarantee that it will work because Oracle MySQL there might have some issues with that, the syntax thing. So you can copy it and run it. And they probably are using schema JSON or something. Anyway, okay, let's see if I can see it in there. Thank you. Okay, to see actually okay, MySQL minus U minus P PHP PP. It actually should work. Okay. Or I have to keep the minus U minus P after this. MySQL use PHP PP. So it's not there. Okay, I don't think it should be the case. It probably just failed because the okay, there is not much stuff in there. Probably there might have some migration related stuff in PHP BB, or it probably uses that JSON file to create those databases using some PHP code and those things. Other than that, if you find another SQL file, you can do it. It probably will not work. The PostgreSQL format, that might work. I'm not sure if there is any SQL stuff. Anyway, it probably is better, I think. Yeah, probably somehow it could not when I were installing. Probably it didn't have enough permission to create those stuff, so it failed or something. But PHP BB installing, that was not our part. Our part was creating the platform and trying to see that we can create multiple URLs. That's the main concept, and the configuration of everything. Those are the main things that I wanted to show. PHP BB, you hardly will use it unless you have a forum related stuff going on. And also check the security aspect of PHP BB, how secure it is. Anyway, for now, that's all. Have fun.